How to build a database on the cloud with CSV files. CSV files are one of the most common ways to store large amounts of data. They're just plain text files, making them easy to open with spreadsheet applications like Excel or to store in a database. However, CSV files do come with its challenges. Large files are difficult and sometimes even impossible to open. And once you do get them open, processing speeds can be slow, making viewing and editing your data a frustrating experience. Using CSV files can also cause disorganization, especially when you have many files you need to manage or complex relationships between your files. Using a database on the cloud is one of the best solutions to manage CSV data. Cloud computing gives you access to data storage that fits the needs of your data, expanding to adjust to increased volumes of data. Compared to on-site databases, cloud databases require less administrative costs, are more safe and secure, and have faster disaster recovery. They can also be accessed remotely. So how can you use your CSV files to build a cloud database? To demonstrate, I'm going to use Akko, which is a cloud-based data management platform that can help you process, store, and manage your data. The first step is to navigate to the Resources tab. This is where we will upload our data and where it will be stored. When we click on Add Resource, we will see two options for uploading flat files, single file and batch files. Single files are, as the name suggests, for uploading individual files. If you have multiple files, all with the same set of columns, you should choose batch files. This will combine all of your files into a single resource for you to use. I'll show you how you can upload your batch files using sample sales data. When we select our files, we'll see a preview of our table. Up at the top, you'll see toggles for safe mode and auto detect. Auto detect will automatically detect each column's name and type. If you encounter any errors, you can use safe mode, which will deal with most issues and set all column types to strings. If you uncheck both, you'll have more flexibility in naming your columns and setting each type. Since auto detect is working well for me, I'm going to select that and upload. This process is similar for single files. Instead, just upload one file. Now we have our resources ready. At this stage, we've already successfully built our cloud database from our CSV files. Just to make sure, let's see what these resources look like. To view and transform our data, we'll need to import our resources into a project. In the project, we'll be able to see the tables that we just uploaded. Each resource will be in a separate tab. Great. This looks like my CSV data. In the toolbar, you'll see a suite of no-code tools to transform your data, such as filtering and sorting, joining tables, pivoting tables, and cleaning data. You can also calculate new columns using formula, or if you have SQL knowledge, use the SQL editor to create more complex actions. If you want to search for a specific piece of data, you can search for it in the search box above the column, or use the filter tool to extract the information. For example, if I'm looking for purchases that fall under the furniture category, I can either type furniture into the search bar or use the filter tool to narrow down the data set. If you want to remove or add files from the batch, you can easily do that in File Management. This feature allows you to easily update your resources, which is very useful since CSV files are generally difficult to update. When you add files, just make sure that the new file has the same columns. When you update your resource this way, you can use DataSync to update your project. This eliminates the need to redo all of your actions when you add to your data. Another way you can update your CSV files besides doing it directly in your resources is by unioning your tables. My two tables here have the same set of columns, so I can use the union action to combine them. Oftentimes, your information will be spread across multiple CSV files, and you'll need to join them to get the complete picture. It's difficult to combine files in Excel, but the join action here is easy to use. Just define what kind of join and which columns to join on. I want to join information about each purchase with the customer who made the purchase. Now you can see that all this data is in one table. As you edit your table, your resources will remain unchanged, allowing you to reuse them for other projects or just to keep as reference. Building a database from CSV files was quick and easy, and now you can enjoy the benefits that come with using a cloud database.